What's up, guys? Welcome back to Caveman Mining. On today's video, we'll just jump right into it. We are going to cover the hashrate hack or update, if you will, from NBMiner. And just to confirm, some of you guys know what this does is it allows 70% of the hash rate, for light hash rate cards. And the version that we want to look for is version 39.0. And I'm running Hive OS. That is my primary means of my mining software. I've done some nice hash and some direct stuff in Windows before, but this is my primary operations. And the release of NBMiner version 39.0 comes with the version of NiceHash OS, we'll just say 2.10.815. Okay, so that was released on the 15th of August. So you have to have at least that OS version to run this. And we've cut to the chase. I have that running right now. And what I want to do in this video is we're going to compare, okay? I'm going to pull up a flight sheet on Ethereum running Trex Miner, and we'll see kind of what this card would normally get with the, full locked hash rate. And then what we'll do is we will then run a test with NBMiner. So let's go to the flight sheet, and I have to look here for, test T-Rex Ethereum. Let's go ahead and apply that flight sheet. And things should start to spool up. And just to recap, the clocks on this card, I'm doing -502 on the core, and I'm pushing a little bit higher on the memory. I'm going 2720, and I'm doing a power level of 121 watts, which should bring us to, in the miner, around 120 watts. So we'll take a look at that momentarily. Let's go ahead and refresh. Things are still spooling up, and what we're gonna do is, this is not the best judge of character to kind of refresh from here. So word of advice is I would go into the Hive shell, okay? And that's gonna show you more accurately or more granularly your hash rate and the timing of everything. And it's gonna show you the shares, okay? Because I've seen some videos where people are claiming these extremely high hash rates. And the fact is, it's more of just the software showing that, but it's not actually truthful reporting because it's not finding shares. So this is kind of the source of truth in going into the miner from shell, and we'll run that. And you can see right off the bat, right, T-Rex miner, again, this is locked. We're running about, starting off at 26.74 mega hash, and I assume that's probably gonna hold. Temperature is pretty cool, 52 Celsius. Power level's 120 watts. Fan is 90%. We get just over 223 on the efficiency, okay? So got one share found here. Let's, we'll just wait for another share to connect. And hash rate is still roughly the same. Temperature going up just a little bit now since the card is starting to hash and kind of get a little bit deeper of a load under its belt. And let's go back to the display here, and let's just see how things look. And looks like Hive is not wanting to play very well. Okay, so it's starting to report the hash rate on this side as well. Got a couple of shares. Okay, 26.74, pretty steady. Now let's, I'm gonna stop the miner and we're going to apply the flight sheet that has the NBMiner new version. So let's get into our flight sheets. I'm gonna run NB test. We're going to apply that. Now, you guys know that once you change your flight sheet with a different miner, it's going to terminate the session with Hive Shell. So we can go ahead and launch a new session. Get that to load and we'll take a peek in there. Just hit enter. And yeah, this is gonna be a really, really interesting test on this Lite HASHRATE 3060 card. I know with the original 3060s that were nerfed, you can do the driver trick. That does not work with the Lite HASHRATE model cards. Just to confirm, the driver model that I'm running here is 465.31. So I believe, if I'm not mistaken, that is the minimum that you can run for the NBMiner version to get the full hash rate. You can definitely look into that. Tell me if I'm wrong, but that's what I believe I heard. And let's go back into Hive Shell. I can already see 31.69, so clearly already starting at a higher rate. Okay, so got our first accepted share, 33.73. Okay, that's not bad for the first share. Obviously, you know, we want to let this run for a little bit of time. I know most people do 24-hour tests. Probably what I'll do with this video is just have the miner running for an hour or two and see where we are at. If there are, you know, huge fluctuations from this first share hash rate, you know, the card gets a little bit hot, and you can already see the second reporting for the hash rate is 33.27 and hasn't found a share yet, a second share yet. So we will keep running this. Power level 120, 54 Celsius, 90 fan. Okay, we've got our second share, so that's a good sign. The more shares in the less time, the better. And hash rate 33.30. Okay, so this is starting to look promising. I'm not blown away by the numbers I'm seeing here, but you know, we're pretty close to on pace with that 70% mark. Okay, so the 3060 cards, when they're at full hash rate on Ethereum with the, you know, the driver hack, around 50 to 52 mega hash. I've seen some cards go as high up as that. So yeah, we're just teetering on getting close to 34 mega hash, which would put us close to 70%. So probably about 67% full hash rate from what I'm seeing here. So pretty close as advertised. Definitely want to see more shares accepted. So I'm not sure if we just need to let the miner run a little bit more time, but yeah, we'll let that run and see where things go. But totally interesting. Okay, another share here. Go back to Hive. All right, yeah, not too shabby. So yeah, 33.76 seems to be the highest hash rate that we've been able to achieve, and still getting more shares. So okay, we'll let that run for a couple hours and we're gonna come back and we'll see where things look. But so far so good. Okay, we'll take a quick break here, and the next edit you'll see on the video, we'll come back and take a look at this after a couple hours, and hopefully we'll see a couple hundred shares maybe by that time if all looks well. So Yeah, cool. Okay, guys, we have let the miner run for about 2 hours and some change. And yeah, things are looking pretty decent. So we're last recorded hash rate about 33.58, 210 accepted shares over the 2 hours, and about 120 watts, 55 degrees, get the fan going at 90% there. So yeah, getting varying hash rates anywhere from the mid to low 33s. And I think the highest share that I saw when I was watching some of the miner logs was about 33.89. So yeah, just shy, just, you know, that point's getting just shy of 34 mega hash. So yeah, my opinion on this is that the future looks promising for the light hash rate cards. I do understand that, you know, we're towards the end of 2021. We all know at some point soon, you know, proof of work is coming to an end for Ethereum. You know, anyone's guessed Q1 2022, which could be, you know, January 1st or could be, you know, April timeframe. We really don't know. But that said, right, we have these great guys with NBMiner cracking, you know, cracking this open and allowing 70% of the hash rate, full hash rate of the card. Things look pretty promising, right? So that said, if you are an Ethereum miner and, you know, you're looking to buy new cards at, you know, MSRP, and they are light hash rate cards, you know, there's some incentive there still to purchase these cards. So yeah, I'm gonna consider it. I'm gonna keep my eye on these different miners and, you know, see who can kind of get win the race to crack the full hash rate. I think it's gonna be a little bit exciting and quite a challenge. But even for now, you know, seeing Ravencoin and Ethereum on the what to mines for, you know, a couple days, just moving up and down on the chart. So obviously Ethereum is still very, very profitable to mine. So yeah, some people might want to consider just, you know, getting the 70% with their cards, whichever card they have with the light hash rate family. So yeah, pretty cool. Like I said, the verdict is I'm pretty happy. I'm not like super blown away by everything, but you know, things looking up. But yeah, I want to cut the video here, guys, and I want to thank you all as always for watching and tuning in. Please feel free to like and subscribe the video if you like what you saw here, and yeah, definitely drop some comments, right, if you thought this was cool, and if you would like to see us, you know, try some different algorithms and do some other things here, just yeah, let us know. And with that, I will chop the video out here. I want to thank you all again. Have a wonderful night, and we will see you on the next video. Thanks for watching Caveman Mining. Bye.